World Sports Action present the official Football League video. The Tottenham Hotspur story, 1988-89. What a hectic pre-season at White Hart Lane. The Spurs pay out over £3.5 million. They capture Paul Gascoigne from Newcastle. And also from Manchester City, the exciting striker Paul Stewart. Manager Terry Venables recoups over £2 million with the sale of half a dozen players, among them Clive Allen to Bordeaux, Steve Hodge goes to Nottingham Forest, and Ozzy Ardiles is another departure. He goes on a free to Queen's Park Rangers. Work also begins on revamping the old South Stand. The building work causes the postponement of Spurs' opening league match. The stand is deemed unfit. The Coventry match is called off on the morning of the game. The league take a dim view of that. So Tottenham have to wait another week before starting their season at Newcastle. An ideal venue for Paul Gascoigne to make his debut. 33,000 are packed inside St James's Park. They see an exciting 2-2 draw.
Anderson with the cross. No, he hasn't got it in yet. No, he plays it short instead to Bogey. Played in a difficult ball there. Spurs in trouble. And it's got in with the number six, Andy Thorne. It's his first goal for Newcastle. And the Spurs defence in total disarray. A dreadful goal for Tottenham to concede. As the ball was played in there, nobody went for it, and it's the number six, Andy Thorne, a former Wimbledon player. They stood looking, those yellow shirts, while Thorne reacted. In really dominant form at the moment, Newcastle. And with men over on this side as well, this is Hendry. Cross coming in, and Darren Jackson! It's two, an almost replica the first goal, as Spurs stand watching again as the ball crosses their six-yard area, and Darren Jackson thumped it joyfully into the back of the net to put Newcastle two up. There he goes, no chance for Mims. Ball ballooning the back of the net again. That's a really good cross again here by Hendry, tempting the defence. Spurs left watching again. So Spurs then with plenty to do, get this second half underway, attacking the goal to our right. Here's Paul Walsh, who had a really lively first half, and Waddle is almost through! And Spurs, in a matter of 10 seconds at the start of the second half, have got themselves back in the game. A sensational start to the second period. And Chris Waddle, the former Newcastle hero, is the man after a good run here by Walsh, who has got Tottenham back into this match. He fought off all challengers, and as he fell, he whacked the ball wide of Besant. And Spurs are back in this match. Thomas with the throw. Walsh, a lovely little turn, chinking away, and the shots really didn't have enough power, and in any case was directed straight at Andy Thorne. But Walsh has looked as good as anybody in the Tottenham side, and it was he, of course, who made the running for Waddle's goal in that dramatic start to the second half. And Waddle at last will get to take the corner. Walsh coming off his man beautifully, Waddle turning it in again, and Fenwick is there! And Spurs are level! Well, the boy that comes from these parts, who's been booked earlier in the game, taking the cross from Waddle with a firm header, wide of Besant, and we're now at 2-2. Great comeback by Tottenham, and questions now to be answered about not only Newcastle in defence, but what their temperament will be now when a game that looked to be so much going their way could now be snatched from them.
Next, it's old rivals Arsenal at White Hart Lane. A crackling match for Gascoigne to make his home debut.
given away by Winterburn. And Adams dispossessing Wolves firmly but fairly. Great play by Adams. Winterburn is clear and Arsenal are into the lead. Brilliant play by Adams to set it up for Nigel Winterburn. Thomas, caught in possession by Paul Allen. Here's Waddle. He's walloped it past Lukic, and Tottenham a level at 1-1. That's a push by Gary Mabbott into the back of Alan Smith. Thomas and Davis plotting over the ball and waiting for Tony Adams to make his way forward. In from Davis. Smith. And now Marwood! Arsenal back in front. And Brian Marwood has now scored in each of Arsenal's three First Division games this season. Tottenham caught out once more. But what an exhilarating start to this North London derby. 2-1 now, 29 minutes gone, and we've had three goals in an eight-minute spell. And Merson dispossessing Mabbott, and here comes Rocastle. Mabbott getting back. Thomas. Winterburn. Tottenham are rocking. It's still Nigel Winterburn. And Smith! Astonishing! It's 3-1 now. It's going Arsenal's way.
Statham. Fairclough looking for movement ahead of him. And Waddle dropped off to find some space. For Gascoigne, and he's lost the boot. Paul Gascoigne with brilliant improvisation. And that will answer a few critics.
Walsh. It's been a difficult afternoon so far for David O'Leary, and there's some more teasing here. Walsh's cross, Samways, the flag is up, it's not going to count, but that must have been a very close thing. Terry Venables saw his side come back from two goals down at Newcastle last week, and he must have thought they'd repeated it here at home to Arsenal.
Arsenal win it 3-2, but Gazza makes his mark. Coming up now, extended highlights of the trip to Anfield.
Ablett. Ray Houghton wearing 10 is onside. One or two indications from Kenny Dalglish that Liverpool might have to change their normal way of playing. But Walsh is round Grobbelaar. The goal is gaping for him. And Steve Nicol with a stupendous piece of covering. To deny his old clubmate. Grobbelaar was nowhere. He charged off his line and one ball out from Tottenham had played Walsh in. They hadn't counted on Nicol. Gascoigne, it's over the head of Ablett and kept in by Waddle. Mabbott on the stretch. The most tentative beginning by Liverpool standards. And Samways stopping the thrust there from Houghton. What an extraordinary opening to the game. The length of the pass enabled Walsh to stay onside. Round Grobbelaar. And Nicol very much the last line of defence, but what an effective one. Paul Walsh, like all players performing against the previous club, very anxious to put on a show. Well, Whelan was almost appealing like a bowler for an LBW decision then. Telford Mills, the referee, was looking the other way. The late contact came from Gascoigne. That is a booking for Gascoigne. With 8 minutes gone. To take the short free kick, receive it from Ablett. And here's Rush. And Mims was angry again with the lack of cover afforded to him. And Bobby Mims knows from past experience that you do not allow Rush to get away from defenders. He swung at it, didn't connect cleanly, fortunately for Tottenham. Houghton. Tottenham holding a squarish back line. Aldridge wanted a little too long, and it was Waddle who dispossessed him, and he's now galloping up to try and support the one forward man, Walsh. And he's got ahead of him. It's a great ball by Walsh. It's a terrific chance for Waddle. And Tottenham, who could easily have been two goals up here in the opening chapter of this First Division match, have missed two chances. Waddle, the second culprit after Walsh. And how many chances do you want at Anfield? This is Aldridge, though. Mims is committed, and he got the ball. It's a save that will mean a lot to Bobby Mims. And the frustration in front of goal at this stage of his Liverpool career is significant, too, for Aldridge. Thomas. Off that time by Houghton, and Whelan can stride forward. Gets the better of Mabbott, and the chance for Aldridge, kicked away by Mims and just away from Rush. Had it just been a block, Rush must have scored from the rebound after Aldridge had tested the goalkeeper. Beardsley. And that's a corner. Aldridge shoots, it was deflected, so Mims did even better. And had it fallen away rather than been kicked away, Rush was right on the spot, as you would expect. Nicol. And that's a great run by Nicol. Outside Houghton, and it nearly got its reward. It's in the end the goal kick. Telford Mills right on the spot to judge, but that was much more like it from Liverpool. Nicol had paired away outside Houghton to make the cross possible. It was back in November when Terry Venables in the suit there took charge of a Tottenham game for the first time. You might remember it was against Liverpool at White Hart Lane. He lost a player sent off after about a quarter of an hour. That was Steve Hodge, and never really had a chance in that one after that. Samways. Now Thomas. Walsh and Waddle waiting in the centre. Here's Walsh. Lets it run for Waddle, and Now that is interesting. It was fairly theatrical, but you might be surprised when I tell you that Tottenham haven't yet had a penalty since Terry Venables took over as manager. They were yelling for one then. Thomas. Whelan leaving it. Forced backman has got Ablett. And now he in turn has Staunton for help, but also Beardsley infield. And Peter Beardsley has struck a goal out of nothing. His 99th in the Football League. To just remind Kenny Dalglish that he is worth a place in the starting lineup. On the stretch, as he was tackled and hurt by Mabbott. But there was absolutely no chance for Mims. Ablett looked to the left, this time ignored Staunton. And Beardsley had pulled away, and Tottenham will be disappointed at the room that Peter Beardsley had. 12 minutes left. The scorer is suffering in terms of the injury. Mabbott, particularly in terms of how the goal came about, looking at it from the Spurs viewpoint. But Kenny Dalglish's side have shown terrific persistence despite their injuries, despite the battle plan being much changed, really, from the usual well-oiled Liverpool machine. Beardsley has shrugged off the damage, his ears ringing to the applause from the cop. And the score is Liverpool 1, Tottenham Hotspur 0. Well, Tottenham, whose response has been to bring on David Howells, their first substitution. Gascoigne and stay them over the free kick. Fenech, 1-1! Quite extraordinary. Liverpool, the ultimate professionals, caught still celebrating Beardsley's goal. Gascoigne delivered it with the accuracy that Fenech was looking for, and he obliged with a superb downward header. And Tottenham, who just had a moment or two perhaps to reflect. Oh, now Fairclough has punched Aldridge. And Telford Mills has to take serious account of this. It was in terms of retaliation, but surely Fairclough has to go. The two goals have fanned the flames in this match. Now, what will this experienced referee do? Fairclough could surely have no complaints if the card is red. Aldridge is incensed. He was on the receiving end of it. Judging by what we've seen from the other Tottenham players, they seem to think that Fairclough will survive. I am beginning to wonder whether that's the case. The law is being laid down very firmly. The card is red. Chris Fairclough is sent off. So Terry Venables, who saw a player sent off when he faced Liverpool in his first match at White Hart Lane last November. That was Hodge, another former Nottingham Forest man, as Hodge was then, goes off this time Fairclough. Now this is what happened. Aldridge clearly started it by turning in, well, I don't know whether he did. There was a collision and then Fairclough raised an arm and followed through. Some more jostling, the kind of which really, I think, was at the root of the Fairclough episode. Certainly nothing too serious, it seemed, as we look at it again from Aldridge's viewpoint. Houghton.
Oh, it's Rush! Oh, my word! How did he miss it?
If ever you wanted an illustration of how a player's timing isn't quite exact, that was it. A very famous example.
Spurs 10 men hold on for a 1-1 draw. Norwich are the surprise leaders and Spurs near the wrong end of the table. Just 2 points and only 4 off the bottom. They need a win to boost their confidence. They get 1-2 against promoted Middlesbrough.
Played towards the near post and Bernie Slaven, that's a big moment for him. His first goal in the first division and Tottenham are behind. Walsh, 5 minutes to go to half-time. Paul Allen, Waddle! And Spurs will feel a bit better at the break. Hamilton spotting the ball up and taking the free kick himself. And Middlesbrough have regained the lead and it was Mowbray who beat Mabbott for the touch. Well, a big crowd here, very disappointed with what they've seen so far. Middlesbrough really adjusting to life in the first division, but Howells got the better of the goalkeeper. That was a very brave header indeed from the Tottenham substitute. What can Tottenham do now? It's Moran, and this is incredible. One substitute has scored, and the other now has gained a penalty from which Tottenham can win the game. Terry Fenwick, 3-2, they're in front at last, and at the right time.
Victory over the Borough, then a 1-1 draw in the Littlewoods Cup tie at Notts County. Chris Fairclough suspended for 2 games after that sending off at Anfield, but Paul Stewart is available for selection, having served his 4-match ban for bookings collected at Manchester City. Spurs' next league games are against Manchester United and Charlton. Stewart is among the substitutes for the United match.
United, who conceded only 1 goal all season in the league, against Spurs, who had their first win last week in really dramatic style against Middlesbrough here at White Hart Lane, with 2 late goals, one of them a penalty. Beaten in the air by Walsh, onto the left foot of Waddle! Well, the remarkable thing there was not that Waddle got his shot in, but that Walsh was able to beat McGrath in the air. Clayton with the goal kick. Sinclair. Cut out by Robson. But the opposing number seven, Walsh, like a real little terrier there. And what a good run, having dispossessed Robson. Trying to get Paul Allen into a shooting position. But Lee Sharp and now Steve Bruce retrieving the situation for Manchester United. Robson. Well, a delightful ball by Robson. Here's the dangerous Davenport. Fenwick watching him and Davenport going on the outside. Fenwick choosing his moment well. Davenport quickly in the action there, having taken a superb pass from Brian Robson, and now Paul McGrath coming up from the back for Manchester United. McClair's in there as well as you would expect. Bruce is there from the back. The ball coming off a Spurs defender for another corner to Manchester United. Strachan will take it. Robson's header, headed off the line by Sam Wayes. McGrath getting in there, and Strachan puts it wide. So, Spurs saved by the header on the line from Vinny Sam Wayes. A tremendous header there by Brian Robson from Strachan's corner. Accurately placed, a tremendous leap there by the Manchester United skipper, and knocked off the line by Sunways. It's like the last 10 minutes of the first half, 0-0. Roddle playing it in, and caught, and then lost by Leighton. The Spurs fans claiming an infringement there by the goalkeeper on Paul Allen. The referee didn't really want to know, but it really looked for a moment as though Spurs might have been onto something. Hughes for Manchester United. Eight minutes of this half remaining. Thomas, compromising bit of defence, and a splendid ball now through to Chris Waddle. And a marvellous goal for Tottenham. One end of the field to the other. And Chris Waddle rams it home. Not bad for a man who woke up this morning with a temperature of 103 and at 7:30 had to call the doctor, but pronounced himself fit to play. And Spurs are delighted that he did. A great ball out of defence, superbly taken in his stride by Waddle. And Spurs go ahead. A goal that will do an enormous amount for this team's confidence. We shall now get a pretty fair indication of what United are worth. Mind you, there's plenty of experience in the side, in the United side, and there's still plenty of time left. Strachan with a little cross. McGrath with a header. Oh, and McClair striking wildly at that one. McClair, in fact, who scored home and away against Spurs last season. Free kick to Manchester United as Mitchell Thomas went on mauling Peter Davenport. Strachan, chipped by him. In fact, it's a tremendous shot there by Mark Hughes. The volley is almost a copyright of Mark Hughes, and he crashed that in on the turn to bring it level to 1-1. I doubt if there's a better volleyer in the game than Hughes, and that really was a superb piece of work. Thomas. Diving header there by Gascoigne, but came to nothing. It's safely with Jim Leighton. As the half-time whistle goes, bristling with good things. A splendid goal by Chris Waddle, putting Spurs ahead after a lovely ball out of defence by Mitchell Thomas. And then a typical volley from Mark Hughes, bringing it back to 1-1. So Spurs then preparing to kick off the start of the second half after a first half that was bristling with so many good things. Score at the moment last season against Manchester United here, but lost 1-0 at Old Trafford. In the crowd and enjoying the sunshine today, Phil Collins, singer, songwriter, star of the film just released, Buster, and a great football fan as well. Gascoigne pulled back by Duxbury, a free kick to Tottenham. Going shot, a long raking shot that the Spurs fans enjoyed. They would have enjoyed it a good deal more, of course, if it just kept inside Nate Leighton's post, but there's some venom there by Paul Gascoigne. Minimum of backlift. So far away. Long ball towards Davenport. Thomas there, but here's McClair. And the substitution now to be made, Chris Waddle goes off. The crowd probably unaware as they boo that he goes off, that in fact he's had troubles all day after waking with a temperature of 103. It was really pretty obvious he wasn't going to last the full 90 minutes, but it does give a first league appearance for Spurs to Paul Stewart. Free kick to United. Strachan. Here's Hughes. McClair waiting there. And United are in the lead. Well, Hughes, the scorer of the first goal, the provider of the second, with an inch perfect cross there. McClair waiting in the middle to get his first league goal of the season. There's the cross, there's the header by Brian McClair. Made for Brian McClair by Mark Hughes. And while we're watching that, Paul Gascoigne has gone off for Tottenham. And David Howes, the number 14 on the ball at the moment, is on for Tottenham. So he now joins the game with a scoreline that reads Spurs 1, Manchester United 2. Here's Olsen. Well, it looked as though it was going to be a good day for Terry Venables. And his side has been playing some good stuff, but the result at the moment going very much against them. To David Howes. Thomas. Anderson. Oh, a lovely little touch by Howells to Samways, and now to Paul Walsh. And Spurs are level. Delight amongst the Tottenham faithful, and a really intricate move of high skill there. Some delightful touches that in the end left Paul Walsh with more time than he was entitled to expect. And that makes it 2-2. Well, an important one that for Walsh. His first goal of the season, an important two for Tottenham. Well, now we're going to get another fantastic grandstand finish. Stewart goes up. It's a Manchester United throw. Really are making quite a habit of saving themselves late in the game. But here's Robson on the break for United, finding Brian McClare. Walsh. Oh, and he's found Stewart. Now, could this open up for Tottenham? Paul Stewart on the charge. Penalty! It looked to me like a shove in the back on Stewart, who was rifling his way towards that United goal. And what an astonishing finish we've got again. Well, what do you think? It looked very much like a shove. And an almost identical situation from last week, when Spurs were down and then scored twice late in the game against Middlesbrough to beat them. The second of them coming from the penalty spot. Now, Fenwick took it last week. And Fenwick, it would seem, has that responsibility this week. No, it's going to be Stewart. And he's missed it! What agony for the man who cost £1.7 million. Well, it makes you wonder, why change a winning formula when Fenwick had scored from the spot last week? And Stewart hit it powerfully enough, shook the crossbar, and the ball bounced out. It stays at 2-2. And we're now right at the end of the game. Up goes Stewart again. Here's Walsh. Bruce with the clearance. Statham trying to get it through to Walsh, and suddenly United are on the counter-attack now, led by Brian Robson. Here's Jesper Olsen. And Olsen not denied, but there's a foul on Howells, and it's a free kick to Tottenham. And Terry Venables, what agony for him after it looked as though Spurs might, for the second successive week, clinch a victory with a penalty right at the end. This time it was not to be. Paul Stewart failed from the spot, and the match finished in a 2-2 draw, with Paul Walsh, with Spurs' second goal, having made sure that at least the home side gets a point.
Charlton certainly boosted by that win at Norwich last week, and really attacking this game with gusto. McKenzie, Peak, who's capable of striking from long range, as he's just shown. Stewart, the flag has stayed down. Stewart's passed Boulder, but he can't keep his balance, and that's a penalty. Well, after Stewart's miss last week, it's back with Fenwick the job. And he took it on with great responsibility and success. 1-1. Gascoigne.
Well,
Tottenham have given a goal away. Andy Jones, the substitute, has scored it.
Walsh
did well to get the cross in. Paul Allen, it's level again with 17 minutes left, 2-2.
So Spurs are 15th after six games, but the league deduct 2 points for failing to play that opening day fixture. It puts them down to 18th place. They get a much-needed win in the Littlewoods Cup second leg against Notts County. In the league, though, things continue to go wrong. Three consecutive defeats, starting at Norwich.
Two former Tottenham players looking to make an impact here. That was Crook to Culverhouse, and now Gordon for Culverhouse again, and for Gordon again. Gordon shots, and Mims did well to keep it out. Another corner to the First Division leaders. Played deeper this time, Rosario! And Spurs found wanting in the air as Robert Rosario came in. Crook. Linegan looking for Fleck and finding him. Townsend's done well in his first start in a Norwich City shirt. Fleck, oh, that's a real poacher's goal. And Tottenham find themselves two down. Samways, Gascoigne. Gary Stevens right in there, so too is Fairclough. 2-1. 12 minutes into the second half. Norwich congregating by the near post, and Linegan got the highest, and Spurs were rooted to the ground again.
Chrissy Waddle. Oh, Walsh is on his way. He's inside the fullback. And again, this is promising. Oh, disaster for Ray Wallace, the fullback. He's turned that past his own keeper. Out by Stewart, only as far as Cockerill, and that is a tremendous goal. Gascoigne. Oof, robbed by Wallace, and here's Cockerill again. And another very good strike by Glenn Cockerill.
Cowan's trying to whip the corner in. It's an own goal! Poor Terry Fenwick. Gascoigne, he's got Waddle to his left. Gascoigne trying to go through the centre, but it might come for Waddle now. And that's a penalty to Tottenham against Nigel Spink. So Fenwick can wipe out the laps at the other end. He's done that. The way McAnally's playing, Tottenham have got to keep tight on him. But he's got some space now, and he's got the power to get away. Daly!
Now Tottenham hit rock bottom. Can things get any worse for Terry Venables' side? Seems so. In the Littlewoods Cup second division, Blackburn hold Spurs to a goalless draw at home. A rare piece of good news, Chris Waddle signs an extension to his current contract. It'll keep him at Spurs until 1995. In the league, though, another home defeat, this time by Derby.
Touch from Moran, now Waddle. Moran had to check back to stay onside. And Waddle whips it in, and it's Paul Stewart. 6 minutes into his eighth appearance for Tottenham. He's got his first goal at long last, and his teammates share his joy and his relief. Callahan. And Mitchell Thomas misjudged that rather badly. McMinn. And Derby have equalised from the tightest of angles, to the consternation of Bobby Mims. McMinn with two to beat, and he's not short of confidence to do that, and Ted McMinn got the angles absolutely right again. Goddard and Saunders reacted the quickest. Dean Saunders, three goals now in two games for Derby.
Defeat by Derby is followed by an encouraging victory at Blackburn. Paul Stewart scores his second goal for Spurs in extra time. And Stewart features prominently again in Tottenham's first live TV appearance of the season at Snowbound Sheffield Wednesday. That's after Wimbledon have come to White Hart Lane.
Fenwick made a good run ahead of the ball, but Samways looked for Waddle. It might come for Fenwick now. He was being tugged back by Dennis Wise, and that is a penalty for Tottenham. Fenwick obliges again. It's an awkward ball for Mims against the Wimbledon big men. Fashanu's flick. And Gibson finally smuggled it over the line. So he comes back to White Hart Lane with a goal. Gibson. Rather labouring to get there, and he couldn't prevent the cross. Fashanu. And Gary Stevens got to him quickly enough, and then Jones got to the ball and to Stevens as well. And Gary Stevens, sadly, has stayed down here. There will always be question marks against Vinnie Jones, but you have to say he played the ball first. But Gary Stevens will take no further part. This match being played now. It was simmering, it's boiling over. Moran, Gascoigne, now Stewart. Useful angle for a cross here. And Paul Stewart looked up for Gascoigne. And Roger Joseph blocked it. Moran, Tottenham's best spell of the match. Gascoigne. That's cleverly done. Stewart peeling away to give him an angle. So too is Waddle. Still Waddle. And good save at the near post by Segers. It's Butters, and would you believe it? Moran. Tottenham roaring forward now. Still Moran. Samways! Now Sanchez. It's a good effort, underside of the bar, Gibson, 3-2.
Is up at the near post. Mitchell Thomas, the 6-footer, is there as well. Paul Stewart, naturally. Terry Fenwick has come up from the back. Mabbott's in there too. And the two substitutes, Howes and Allen, waiting now for Chris Waddle to deliver the decisive ball. But in the end, Sterling turns away, hammers it clear. But Air Clustal all the time in the world. Plays the ball through again towards Paul Stewart. It was held up for a minute. An astonishing goal. And Spurs are in the lead. Well, Turner came herring out of his goal. Outside the box. It was followed up by Paul Stewart. And he'll claim that.
Well, we thought the goal, if it did come, would come from a mistake. It held up. Turner possibly mistimed it. And that's how goals are scored. They come from mistakes, but you must admire Stewart's perseverance there.
So, Paul Stewart. His third of the season after that £1.7 million move from Manchester City. Well, it was a moment of great relief for Terry Venables. He's watching it now, and there's the moment, and it's in the net. Alan Harris is number two, looking much more delighted than Terry himself.
Eustis, the new Sheffield Wednesday manager. Excellent coach who's no doubt learned an awful lot under Howard Wilkinson, the 5.5 years he was here with him. But now Stewart on the break again for Tottenham. Could make it safe for them. Paul Stewart! 2-0! That big fee is being paid off in large lumps now. And Spurs seem to be en route for a third successive win. One in the Littlewoods Cup, one in the league against Wimbledon, and now with Stewart hammering in that second goal, it looks very much as though it could be another victory in the league for Tottenham.
He's got tremendous power, the boy, hasn't he? He looks as strong as a bull when he's in full flight, and I think now he's beginning to find his first division legs.
And that was really good clinical finishing right at the end there, one against one. And the goal seen from the other angle. Again, we see the power and the pace and the running of Paul Stewart. Shaking off Cranston is not an easy thing to do, but there, the real good clinical finishing there as Turner came towards him. And Paul Gascoigne. With the mascot as well, Gascoigne.
Gascoigne and the whole club enjoying Spurs' second win in a row. It lifts them off the bottom. They're now 17th. But a blow. Gary Stevens will miss the rest of the season after that controversial tackle by Vinnie Jones snapped his knee ligaments. In the league, Tottenham draw their next two home games against Coventry and Queen's Park Rangers.
Paul Gascoigne will take. That's aimed at Butters. Stewart, Mitchell Thomas is in there, and Stewart again. Paul Stewart back in the groove. 3 in 2 games for him. David Speedy, and Coventry pouring forward here. Phillips with some space, and there are men over on the far side. Houchin's one of them. 1-1, Keith Houchin loves scoring against Tottenham.
Pizantic. Faraday. It wasn't the best cross in truth.
Oh, and it's fallen for Falco, who bites the hand that used to feed him.
Rangers continuing to take the fight to Tottenham.
And they continue to defend badly. It's presented a goal for Trevor Francis. It came off Butters. Gascoigne. Oh, and Seaman never moved. That's changed the picture somewhat.
Ardiles. Trying to work the ball to safety, and now he's given it away. Samways.
Waddle!
Spurs appeal successfully against the deduction of 2 points. They'll keep the points, but must pay a fine of £15,000. The league position improves. They're 15th with 15 points. In the Littlewoods Cup, they lose out to Southampton, 2-1 at the Dell. As they enter December, Spurs have a game at Everton before derbies against Millwall and West Ham. First, let's go to Goodison Park and the match against another of the big spenders, Everton.
Snowden. Sharp, a lovely header down from Bracewell. Bracewell. Nicely executed. Snowden.
Cotty, the flag has stayed down, and it's Tony Cotty! His 100th goal in league football.
And Gascoigne arrogantly losing the call. Not quite enough weight on the final pass, otherwise Waddle would have been clear at the end of a sweeping Tottenham move. Gascoigne again. Brilliantly done, splendidly done, and Ratcliffe just quick enough to stop that virtuoso show by Gascoigne leading to a Spurs equaliser. Samways. in from Waddle. Oh, and Southall, an extraordinary save to prevent what would have been an own goal. Gascoigne. Stewart, oh, and through the middle is Gascoigne. He's round Southall, and Stuart McCall with a fantastic clearance off the line.
Paul Allen, Millwall back in numbers. Here's Waddle, he might try one from there. He does! Oh, that's a superb goal by Chris Waddle. Gascoigne, Stewart in. That will have to be a free kick. Harry Horn lining up his wall. Gascoigne and Waddle over the ball, and Gaz has curled one. Took everybody by surprise. Tottenham's Geordie connection strikes again. Is Stewart. Oh, and they've let Walsh in. Will it roll? Just past the post. Here's Gascoigne again, and he's really enjoying himself now as Tottenham turn on the style. On he goes. Oh, good effort, and a marvellous save.
Seasonal spirits aplenty at Upton Park for this London derby. Spurs arriving, their own spirits much higher now, particularly Paul Gascoigne, an entertainer with a rich supply of material. And for the first 20 minutes, it was the Gascoigne show, carving out here the game's first opening for Paul Stewart. Another superb surge from midfield by Gazza. West Ham melting away in front of him. A run almost rounded off with a goal. And at this stage, Gascoigne irresistible. Every Tottenham attack was stemming from him. More splendidly created play. And finding Gary Mabbott in the clear, Alan McKnight rescuing the Hammers. For Terry Venables, all that was missing in this spell of Spurs supremacy was a goal. And Gascoigne close again to supplying it. He dominated the match until an ankle injury, which left him unable to come out for the second half. Ironically, as West Ham started to emerge from their shell, they fell behind. Leroy Rossini's header down, and the Hammers looking dangerous. But Mabbott sensing the opportunity to counter-attack. A powerful and purposeful break. Supported by Paul Walsh. And he in turn by Chris Waddle. And Mabbott still forward to volley in the half clearance, 1-0 to Tottenham in the 23rd minute. West Ham have had a much needed upswing in their recent results, and Alvin Martin was soon testing Bobby Mims. Mims played well, despite living now in the shadow of the Norwegian Erik Tortsvedt. But in the second minute of the second half, he was relieved when Liam Brady's aim was just off target. But Tottenham, even without Gascoigne now, continued to create. A good advantage played by referee Darrell Reeves. Walsh's cross, Stewart's header grasped right on the line by McKnight. The game was held up for 3 minutes when police came onto the pitch to quell a disturbance in the terracing. West Ham rightly proud of Upton Park being fence-free. The referee and the police in close liaison and in control. The matter, though, will be reported to the Football Association. Spurs, though, not disrupted by the stoppage. Walsh cleverly freeing Mitchell Thomas. 71 minutes gone, 2-0 to Tottenham.
Two wins just before Christmas and Spurs are on the march. Now they're 11th. The playing staff has a real international flavour about it. Venable signs the keeper, Erik Thorsvedt, from Gothenburg. From Barcelona comes Naheem and Bergsson from Iceland. After the busy Christmas programme, only Bergson's called into first team action. Bobby Mims keeps his place as Spurs play Luton and Newcastle at home before the Arsenal derby at Highbury and another live TV appearance. First though, it's Luton.
The story at White Hart Lane revolved around this push by Luton's Steve Foster on Spurs former Luton forward Paul Walsh. Now, Terry Fenwick, Tottenham's leading scorer, was 5 out of 5 from the penalty spot. Now, he's 5 out of 6. Les Seely's save, and when the ball rolled back, Fenwick scooped it over. It finished 0-0.
Next up, struggling Newcastle at White Hart Lane on New Year's Eve. Paul Allen inspiring the first goal. His precise pass, finding Stewart. Stewart's cross turned in by Walsh. That only Walsh's second goal of the season. The second on the half hour from Chris Waddle, but the free kick taking a wicked deflection and stranding Dave Besant in the Newcastle goal. That's 3 wins in 4 games for Tottenham, and next, Highbury.
Arsenal manager George Graham and his Tottenham counterpart Terry Venables have been close friends for years, so despite a wide gap in the league placings between the two clubs, the knowledge the teams had about each other always suggested a close game, and that was the way it was. Even though Arsenal scored midway through the first half, Paul Merson's third goal in 4 games, further evidence of the maturing of the 20-year-old striker. Tottenham then had a justifiable claim for a penalty turned down, missed good chances to equalise and were still very much in the match until the final minute. Then Arsenal broke away, Merson very much involved again, and it was Michael Thomas who got full reward for galloping up in support. Tough on Tottenham, but 3 more points for the leaders.
Another defeat in the FA Cup away to Bradford City, so Spurs must hope to make progress in the league. They meet Nottingham Forest in the latest live TV game. Erik Torsved makes his debut. Sadly, his blunder cost Spurs the match.
So Torsved, 26 years old, played in Stavanger in Norway, then had a little spell in the West German First Division at Borussia Mönchengladbach, and arrived here from Gothenburg this week. Carr now playing it in for Parker. He's got him behind them, and the shot comes off the post, and Fenwick puts it behind. It's a real torrid time in that goal for Erik Torsted at the moment. Parker. Oh, a lovely ball. Chapman now faced with the goalkeeper and the Spurs defence wide open, and he's missed it. Walsh. And now Allen, a lovely touch from Stewart. Paul Allen, and Waddle! Now Stewart, 2 great pieces of goalkeeping, and 3 by Steve Sutton. What fabulous keeping there. Webb playing it in, Chapman couldn't gather. And Brian Laws, a little flick on, and Parker, it's in there! Parker for Nottingham Forest. Over again. Now Nigel Clough. Long range shot. Through the keeper's arms. A terrible mistake by Torsved. And it's 2-0. Well, that's a nightmare start for the Norwegian. Nigel Clough. A real howler. There's Carr on the far side. Delightful ball there by Parker for him. Now, has he got a trick to beat Houghton? Oh, that time the keeper saved. Fenwick again. Nice turn there by Paul Allen. Walsh, will Allen go all the way? He's taken it too wide. Mabbott trying to get in there. Kicked away there. Steve Hodge.
Wilson.
Walsh waiting in the middle. Waddle's in there! A thundering header there from Chris Waddle.
Next, a trip to Teesside to play Middlesbrough, followed by another live match and another defeat at Manchester United. The action from Ayersham first.
Gascoigne, and that's a rather sloppy ball played across the face of his own defenders, and it's Cooper who won it and scores a great goal for Middlesbrough, but a bad one from the Tottenham viewpoint.
Waddle's corner, helped on by Howells.
This is Stewart who beat the goalkeeper in the air. Stewart! Well, a goal either side of half-time from Paul Stewart. Tottenham lead 2-1.
Can Spurs hang on here? Parkinson. Davenport trying to wriggle away through, and Ripley couldn't miss from there.
Strachan for Manchester United. Hughes again to Strachan. Can he get across in? McLaren! United ahead.
So just 1 point from four games. In fact, 1 point in 1989. Spurs slip back to 13th place. Paul Stewart picks up his sixth booking of the season at Old Trafford. He's certain to be suspended again. The next league games, they're home to Charlton and to Norwich, going so well. Then a visit to Southampton. The Charlton match launches a fine run of seven games without defeat.
And Waddle for once went down a blind alley that time. And there's a huge gap here between Bergson and Fenwick that Paul Williams might exploit, and has done. Gascoigne. Stewart. Look at the number of players Charlton have got back. Fenwick. Now that will be a Spurs free kick. Taken quickly by Mabbott. Stewart!
Naeem's got some space. Here he is. Oh, that's a glorious ball. And Gascoigne's onside. Must score, surely. Yes. Quality finishing from Paul Gascoigne. Go the heads. Rosario's challenging. Dale Gordon, good stop. Putney. Gascoigne. Here's Waddle. Prepared to take Butterworth on. He's got the legs to beat him as well. Oh, and he squeezed one into the near post. Chris Waddle.
Tottenham looking to play their way out of trouble, not betraying their natural instincts, even on the soggiest pitch of the season. And Waddle stole the yard on Statham and scored in superb fashion. Danny Watts, Shearer on the chase, Torsvets come, and that was a bad foul. The card is yellow, it could easily have been red. Waddle, they just don't know how to stop him. Still Waddle, how does he do it? Well, it was Osman who stretched a leg over which Waddle finally fell. Well, it's Naeem placing the ball and taking the free kick quickly and perfectly. His first goal for Spurs, a superb free kick.
What a marvellous goal from Chris Waddle. Spurs 11th. But just look at that massive gap, 21 points between them and the leaders, Arsenal. Now Spurs meet the men of the Midlands. Away trips to Derby, to Coventry and to Nottingham Forest. And first of all, another home win against the Villa.
Walsh, lovely turn. Waddle's on his way, twisting and turning, he's in! Oh, I say, Chris Waddle! Waddle again, oh, he's unstoppable! 2-0 Tottenham!
a double here over Tottenham. Saunders got one of their three goals at White Hart Lane, and he's looking to score here at the baseball ground. He's done just that, leaving a stream of defenders in his wake. Gascoigne. Oh, and he's beaten Shilton, who seemed to have it covered, but it got past him, and Shilton is furious. Gascoigne is delirious.
Phillips for Coventry, who are beginning to find one or two gaps. And there's another one for Smith. Torsfeld's come to meet him, and Gary Bannister will walk that in. And here's Chris Waddle. Oh, and that's a lovely goal by Chris Waddle. 1-1.
Barker. Pierce just kept it in play. It rather bounced off Clough. But here's Hodge. And Parker is in the right place to score again, just as he was against Manchester United in the FA Cup on Saturday. One. Advantage play. And Walsh drives it in. Sutton's lost it. And it's David Howells who's on hand to equalise. Waddle, and Tottenham showing no signs of settling for a point here against the side, remember, 18 games unbeaten. On goes Waddle. Walsh and Samways. What a comeback.
What a good run. 4 wins out of 6, and that means Spurs in the top 8 for the first time this season. There's another win coming up on the tricky plastic surface at Luton, but that's after one of the great occasions of the season, the visit of Liverpool to White Hart Lane.
Forward by Fenwick, good ball to Stewart. Walsh in the middle in support. Oh, he's so strong, and then he goes down on the edge, and he has given this time. Stewart, so strong, crashed through the first challenge, the second one brought him down. Inside the penalty area, the linesman flag, and referee Roger Milford instantly agreed. Inside the box. Ablett's tackle again. Terry Fenwick, who scored a few from the spot already this season, 5 in fact, has missed just one against Bruce Grobbelaar to give Spurs the lead. To the second half for Tottenham. Fenwick's penalty, Spurs 1, Liverpool 0. Our camera from inside the goal showing how sweetly that was struck by Terry Fenwick, sending Grobbelaar the wrong way. Fenwick on the score sheet in both games in the league against Liverpool this season then, but now he's really set the cat among the pigeons. Should make this one heck of a game, and here come Liverpool straight away with Whelan. Well, Allen had nowhere to go. Houghton challenged him, and he goes down, and it's another penalty. Astonishing. 2 penalties in the space of a minute. That's one for the record books. Allen's challenge on Houghton, and the referee again perfectly placed to decide. Penalty. So, John Aldridge has the chance immediately to level matters. What a sensational start to the second half this is. No pause for breath, but I'll bring Ray Clemens in a moment. John Aldridge has scored 3 times from the spot in his 22 goals for Liverpool this season. None have been as important as this. It's 1 each, Aldridge. Well, we always felt this game would produce goals, but who could have dreamed they would both come from the penalty spot and be less than a minute apart? Spurs 1, Liverpool 1,
Aldridge cancels out Fenwick's kick immediately. Howells for Spurs, it's 1-1. Barnes wins it back, now Wheeler, Houghton. Aldridge in space here and he's found him. Brilliant finish! Peter Beardsley hammers it into the net and this time there can be no question. Beardsley went one way, Aldridge went the other. Beardsley was picked out and the finish was spot on. Lovely through ball and Beardsley just picked his spot. 2-1 to Liverpool.
Priest with the Luton corner. And Foster got free. That looked a foul throw to me. David Howells battling for this one and getting his reward. Mabbott hit the post. Walsh. Broken up by Fenwick. Gascoigne. He's got players right and left. Gascoigne doesn't need them. Can he finish it now? He can. A fantastic goal by Paul Gascoigne. And Chris Waddle gives it the stamp of approval.
Absolutely brilliant from Gazza. And now Spurs face two more struggling clubs, West Ham United and Sheffield Wednesday. It's the Hammers first.
Waddle. West Ham still defending stoutly, but they've lost Naim here. Ward. McAvenny. Oh, it's a terrific free kick by Waddle, and Park's got a touch. Gale trying to hold up Stewart. Walsh taking over. And Phil Parks keeping West Ham alive here. Stewart. Parks has got to come. That's one of the most blatant penalties of the season. Parks on Stewart. Here goes Fenwick. It's got to be retaken. Same place, same result. And it stands this time. Well, there's nothing left to do for West Ham but to try and push on, and they've left Stewart, the flag has stayed down, and Phil Parks has had precious little protection on the day he celebrates 20 years in football.
Pearson jumping, that's come for Bennett. Oh dear, he knows he should have scored. Waddle, again teasing Wednesday. He's found the byline and a good cross. Howells! Well, somehow Turner kept that out. Waddle. Houghton's cross. Howells again. What a terrific stop.
No goals, but Spurs are seventh, and that's an excellent position when you remember the way they started the season. Spurs still with four games to go. The next two are impressive wins against Everton and away at Wimbledon.
Waddle's jumping. Here's Stewart. Oh, and he squeezed that in. And he enjoyed it too. Fenwick for Tottenham. Walsh twisting first one way and the other, and Waddle's in. Another one for Tottenham's leading scorer. Wise then with a kick, plenty to aim at. Eric Young. Well, they've got one back.
The home match with Everton takes place a week after the Hillsborough tragedy. The club removed the fences before the game. The fans pay their tribute to Merseyside.
Tottenham do look much more secure playing this way. The sweeper was an inventive thought by an inventive manager here, Terry Venables, but the players somehow never felt fully in tune with it. Walsh looks to chip Southall. A brilliant goal. Coming in the 69th minute. And Paul Walsh beats a high-class goalkeeper with a wonderful shot. Stephen. Watson goes up. Sharp might have a shot here. Graham Sharp. Oh, and it's drilled in by Neil McDonald. 1-1. 7 minutes left. Everton with numbers there, and eventually the ball broke for McDonald, and a similar goal really to Paul Walsh's. Stewart. And it falls for Walsh. Can he get there before Southall? He has done. He scored again in the last minute. Stewart made it happen with the first shot. It couldn't have ricocheted better for Walsh. And he took it early and crisply this time.
Spurs take the points on a difficult day to concentrate on football. But now, they're fifth. Millwall have had a fine first season in Division 1, but they catch Spurs in rampant mood.
Brierley rather misjudging his jump. Ran on to Waddle. Oh, and here's Walsh! A close-range header. Allen. For Walsh, who lets it run to Stewart. Back for Allen. This is nice from Tottenham. And they get the reward. A goal for Paul Stewart. Stewart. Walsh. The two first-half scorers combining well to give Stewart his second. Well played by Gascoigne. This is Stewart. And now Naeem. And Samways stabs in number four. There's really an exhibition feel about Tottenham's football now. And Paul Stewart is on a hat-trick. He's got it!
Spurs can look back with pride on championship form over the last third of the season. The last 14 games produced 31 points. And if you compare that to the first 23, 6 wins and only 26 points. It looks good for next season. Not even defeat in the last match at Queen's Park Rangers can take the shine off that optimism. Ironically, it's a former Spurs player, Mark Falco, who does the damage at Loftus Road, and only 5 minutes from the end of the season. So, a very creditable sixth position for Tottenham. Out of 38 games, they finished with 15 victories, 9 of them in the last 14 games. They scored 60 goals, conceded 46, and you've seen them all. Chris Waddle was top scorer with 14. Paul Stewart began repaying that transfer fee. What a contribution he made. Terry Fenwick got 9 in all competitions, Paul Gascoigne 7, and Paul Walsh got 6. But it was Chris Waddle who was most impressive over the season, scoring top quality goals. The best from Chris Waddle came on a dreadful surface down at the Dell against Southampton.